Here we are in a beautiful early morning, blue skies, Clovis, California day, looking at a way too cool 1958 Chevrolet Yeoman 2dr Wagon. You don't see many of these, done in a resto mod format. Handled several cars for a collection here. I'm going to kind of give you a walk around and give you a feel like we usually do. We've actually had this up on the lift here, and we've got a cool undercarriage video for you on it. Kind of share the whole car top to bottom like we generally do. Has a nice factory trim and style to it. It's finished in a base coat, clear coat, jet black. Pretty hard to do a black car, and this one presents itself very well. You can see the reflections in the panels, that type of thing. Not a lot of window trim on the back side here with these Yeoman wagons. They were kind of like the handyman type wagon. Super low production car, I believe. We'll go to Spud's garage and kind of give you some specs on it. It has 22-inch Coy wheels on the rear. It has Wilwood disc brakes all the way around, power disc brakes. Up front it has 20-inch wheels, again Coy's, five spokes. Little bit of indicator what's underneath the hood there as you take a look at the fender badge, the fuel injection fender badge. Quite some surprises on the Restomod format. Suspension wise, retains, it's resting on a body off style restoration, so the chassis has been powder coated, that type of thing. Factory suspension configuration, but nicely updated with high end Ridetech engineering suspension components. Tubular control arms in the front, coilover adjustable suspension in the front, stabilizer bar, that type of thing in the rear, same thing. Factory coil type springs with the Ridetech components, strong arm components in the back. There's a lot of bright work and chrome on a car like this, and this thing is just beautiful. I couldn't even imagine what it costs to plate that bumper. Kind of will get you underneath the hood here shortly, but you can kind of tell there's something a little bit extra underneath the hood. It has a nice big block Camaro engine style vents on the hood of it. Otherwise, factory smooth roof and hood. Underneath the hood here is where you'll get the surprises. Underneath the hood is a 2015-ish Camaro ZL1 supercharged LSA V8. Lots of horsepower on it, way too cool. It's been upgraded with a 4L80E automatic overdrive transmission. It has a 411 posi rear differential in it. Again, with all the strong arm engineering components on it, Ridetech. Very straight. Way too cool. Kind of give you a look at the front end there. The shade here kind of gives you a feel. Factory badges here on the side. Again, the Wilwood 4-piston, 13-inch in the front. There's a very nicely done bucket seat interior. And some nice little touches as we go through here. The interior is finished in a good wearing ultra leather and a high-end pile carpet. You'll see a nice diamond pattern to it. These actually are dual power seats, also out of a Camaro, modern Camaro, but they've eliminated the headrest off of it when they reupholstered them because they didn't want those sticking up looking funky. Anyway, the dash is a factory style, nice little hand-built console, floor mats that match the carpet on it, AC vents down here. Loaded up with air conditioning, power steering. All the window garnish and moldings, including around the rear compartment, all that was dipped and then clear coated in a carbon fiber look, which is just cool. You don't see a lot of that when it comes to interior trim or somebody taking that extra time. You'll also see it on the console here. Center portion. Get you to the back seat. There's seat belts front and rear. Retractable style seat belts up front. Door jam to door jam. Very nice. Cost a lot of money to build a car like this. Just imagine the engine conversion. When we get underneath the hood, it's very nice and tidy. 12-inch Wilwood disc in the back. Again, the 22-inch Coy's wheels in the rear. Has a Magnaflow exhaust system on it. Again, we'll get underneath the hood and cover all that for you like we typically do. You peek down the side here. Nice little wagon. The battery's been relocated in the back. We'll cover that when we open up the deck. Kind of give you a feel of the rear compartment. Beautiful day here. On the road, drastic. I wouldn't say it's got a lot of horsepower, but as far as cosmetics, it just has a good subtle Restomod feel. You would never know a supercharged 500 and some odd of horsepower late model V8 underneath the hood. All the factory bodywork, like we talked about. Little tiny mark right here, but I mean, you could. It's just a really nicely done car. Again, the trim, diamond here, dual power seats, retractable seat belts, factory VINs here where it's supposed to be. It's not been moved or relocated. Has a tilt steering column in it. Center console with cup holders. Back seat, again, like we talked about. Gonna fire it up here. I'm actually gonna pull it over just a little bit so I can get some light off the dash here, so I can kind of give you a feel of the gauges. I'll take you for a little spin. Anyway, fits in the factory compartment, so if you like a different style of gauge, it would be easy to do. It has Dakota Digital gauges in it, all fully functional, 13 volts, the RPM gauge, miles per hour, water's at 141, oil pressure's at 40, fuel's at 54%, factory light switches here, custom auto sound radio. Again, the console's done here. It has R134 vintage air conditioning with the vintage billet controls here. They've done the carbon fiber that I talked about on the window, all the window garnish moldings, front to rear. They've also done it here. They carried it through to the steering wheel. Got a cool sound. Hang on, we'll take you for a ride. All right, we'll get you underneath the hood. Like we talked during the walk around, this is just way too cool for school underneath the hood here. Very nicely done. Around a 2015 Camaro ZL1 LSA supercharged V8 underneath the hood here. Nicely presented. Everything's nice and tidy underneath the hood. The body off restoration and under the hood here is just super clean. We're going to kind of identify a few things under the hood here and give you a good feel of the engine compartment. Factory style engine cover here with a carbon fiber look. Wanted to share these control boxes here. This control box here, and access to the computers and everything is super easy on this car. It's well thought out. Has this box right here is an engine management box, so it'll have all your fuses and some of your modules and things like that. There's a transmission management box right there, again accessible, so you can kind of connect to things. Over here is the body management wiring. And this control box over here next to the master cylinder. It's a Wilwood master cylinder, power brakes, four-wheel disc brakes. Bottom of the hood's finished like the rest of the car. This car had about 13, or this donor engine had about 13,000 miles on it. It's been updated with the 4L80E automatic overdrive, because I believe you can only get the Camaro ZL1 in a 5-speed. So they've, up front here, they rearranged it and put a AC compressor on. Has a power steering pump down here for the factory steering. These are Holley components, serpentine belt drive brackets that you can buy. Again, nice and tidy. This is a air intake. These LS motors really enjoy fresh air, so it's got a filter box in the fender apron here, so it's bringing a nice cool air. They utilize the Camaro cooling system up front here. The supercharger intercooler is right here. The recovery tank, or the water for the intercooler, is right there. The AC condenser is behind that, and the radiator is behind that. This is the coolant reservoir for the factory radiator. This is the power steering reservoir for the power steering that's located down there. Again, the updated front suspension, tubular control arms, all that kind of thing. Kind of give you an idea here. We're going to fire it up in just a minute for you.
Want to give you a good
computer control. We're going to fire it up. Get you into the back of the wagon here. I know the light's going to be a little bit odd, so I'll study over on this side. Same type of high-end ultra leather in the back here, perforated panels, nice carpet, overall finish very nice back here, chrome tailgate hinges. The battery's been relocated to right here in the back. Still has a nice little tool well back here. Now, got an extra secondary mat. Shut this back down there. Secondary mat to protect your carpet. Same thing on this side, the perforated leather panels. Nice stitching. The window garnish moldings are also the same way. They've been carbon fiber dipped and then clear coated. Same thing with all the trim on the back here. Thank you for a spin down the road here, kind of give you a feel. Been in drive, pull it up a little bit, we'll just rev it up. Automatic's very cool in this, supercharged. What do you got underneath the hood there? Power steering. Alright, we're going to take it back to his garage. Make sure you go to Spud's garage. Have a great day. Alright, we have a benefit of a lift today. We'll share the undercarriage here with you. As we mentioned during the walk around, full body off restoration on this one. The chassis was completely stripped and powder coated. Factory frame, there wasn't any reason to modify that. Get up here, they actually I'll turn around here. The fuel tank's been changed to a later model Chevy flat pan style, and the battery's been relocated in the spare tire well back there. Just makes it easier to access stuff. Put things, fuel filter up here where you can get to it. Has all the suspension on it, front to rear, is the Ride Tech Engineering strong arm suspension, so it's engineered for this chassis. The rear end is a factory rear differential that's been gone through 411 gears, posi in it, so it'll definitely handle the 500 plus horsepower that's under the hood. The strong arm control arms here, rear control arms, coil types, rear suspension, nice ride in the back. Ride Tech shocks are expensive. You'll say you use braided lines on the Wilwood disc, 12 inch in the rear. Nice and clean underneath here. The exhaust is stainless, custom stainless, polished mufflers. Floor pans are solid, all the rockers, that type of thing. You see they put seat belts in it. They use the correct hardware here, so it's safe. Custom cross member here. It has Magnaflow polished stainless mufflers on it. There's the 4L80E automatic transmission. We'll turn around and take a quick spin back too so you catch it from the other angle. Up front, same thing. Ride Tech Engineering adjustable coilover front suspension, tubular control arms, engineered for this car. That's not cheap, a cheap date, this suspension in this car. Up front, Wilwood disc, braided lines, 13 inch slotted rotors. Factory steering on it. Bottom of the ZL1 Camaro LSA engine there. Kind of give you a feel. nice and clean. Drive this one, that's for sure. Again, the powder coated chassis will just take you back through the other view here. Appreciate you hanging around. Make sure you go to Spud's Garage. We'll have plenty of still photos. I took a bunch. Factory V8 rear differential again. Beefed up posi 411. See the strong arm on the control arms here. Alright, taking it back to his garage. Could be going to your garage. Make sure you go to Spud's Garage.